In this video, we're going to explore some techniques for troubleshooting email problems in PI notifications 2016 R2 or later. We will walk through a troubleshooting example where a user did not get their daily notification email as expected. We are using a simple architecture where PI notifications service 2018 SP2 is installed on PI client 01 and the SMTP server is installed on PI SRV01. Let's say we have a daily alarm notification that is configured to send a notification every day at 6:30 a.m. We can see here under the trigger pane that this notification is triggered by the 6:30 a.m. alarm event frame generation analysis. Under subscriptions, view edit subscriptions, we can see that the notification is configured to send an email to one student 01 at the start of the event frame generated by the 6:30 a.m. alarm analysis. From the analysis tab, we can check the logic of the event frame generation analysis. Based on this logic, a 0-second event frame should be generated when the analysis is triggered at the specified schedule of 6:30 a.m. This type of analysis logic, where the start trigger condition and the end trigger condition both evaluate to true, is often seen when the purpose of our notification is to be an alarm. The start and end triggers are both set to true in this case for simplicity. However, it could be any logic where both the start and end triggers evaluate to true. We can find the event frames generated for this element by right-clicking on the element, Find Event Frames. These are all the event frames generated by all analyses under this element. When a notification is sent for an event frame, the notification service will create an annotation on the event frame with information such as number of subscribers, the send status, the send time, etc. This annotation will have a description that will tell us whether a notification was sent successfully or not. We can check the annotation description by right-clicking on today's event frame. Select Properties. Click on Annotations. Annotation description is not a default column, so we will have to add it by clicking on this gear icon and selecting Description. We can expand the column for more details. We see that the send status is failed. This means that the notification service attempted to send an email, but it failed. So how can we troubleshoot this? Before starting the troubleshooting process, we first need to ask ourselves what changed in our system recently. The answer might lead to the root cause of the issue and save us a lot of time. If you don't know what changed, then the first thing we need to do is check the message logs around the time that the notification email should have been sent. Let's check the logs from PI client 01 since the PI notification service is installed on that machine. The PI notification service logs are stored in the Program Data OSIsoft PI Notifications Logs directory. The archive folder stores the logs for the past 7 days by default. If the occurrence we are troubleshooting was in the past few days, we would want to check the message log in those files as well. However, since our issue started today, we'll focus on this one. By default, the log level is information. If there are no messages in the log about the failure, we might need to increase the debug level to trace on the PI notification service. Steps on how to do that are provided in the article linked in the description below. We can see in the logs that the PI notifications service failed to send the email because it could not reach the SMTP server at the time the issue occurred. let's send another test email to verify whether or not the issue is still happening. We can send a test email using the email delivery channel plugin in Pi System Explorer. Go to the Contacts tab, Tools, Delivery Channel Plugins. Right-click on Email. Select Settings. Here, we see that the primary SMTP server is Pi SRV01, and we connect to it through port 25. We don't have a backup SMTP server, so if we fail to connect to the primary SMTP server, we will not have another SMTP server to fall back on. Another important parameter is the send email. While it would not cause the error that we've seen in the logs, the send would fail if it were specified in an incorrect format. Click on Test. It will send a test email to student01. All right, looks like it fails the same way. This indicates that there might be something blocking the connection. Let's make sure that we can connect to Pi SRV01 through port 25 from Pi Client 01. From Pi Client 01, using Windows PowerShell, we will run the following command to verify that TCP port 25 is open on Pi SRV01. If this returns a blank output, that means that the port is open. Otherwise, an error will be thrown. Running the command returns an error. This indicates that we cannot connect to Pi SRV01 via port 25. Perhaps an admin enabled Windows Firewall on Pi SRV01 where the SMTP server is installed and did not create a firewall rule to allow connections from all essential applications. At this point, it would be good to involve your IT department, as most users don't have access to SMTP servers. I happen to know that this is a firewall issue, so let's go to Pi SRV01 and open the port. On Pi SRV01, open Windows Firewall with Advanced Security. We can see that Domain Firewall is on. Let's proceed to create a rule that allows inbound connections via port 25. If the port was open on the server and still couldn't connect via port 25, it could mean that there is a network firewall blocking the connection. In that case, please contact your IT department for further investigation. In this case, it is a Windows firewall, so we will go ahead and create a rule for port 25. Under Actions, click on New Rule. We'll select the Port Radio button. Next, the port number will be 25. Next, for the purpose of this video, I'll leave the rest of the settings as default. Consult with your IT department for specific recommendations at your company. I'll call this rule SMTP server inbound port. Let's go back to Pi Client 01 and verify that the port is now open. From PowerShell, I'll rerun the same command to test the connection to Pi SRV01 through port 25. All right, it looks like it's successful now. From Pi System Explorer, let's test send another. All right, that was successful as well. Finally, we can recalculate our analysis from today and verify that we received a notification email. To backfill the analysis, right-click, select Backfill, Recalculate. Since event frame generation analyses cannot be backfilled, the automatic selection will be a recalculation. This will permanently delete event frames in the time range selected and create new ones. Click on Start. All Right, now that it has completed, let's verify the annotation description. Looks good. From Microsoft Outlook, logged in as student 01. We can see that the notification generated as a result of the recalculation has been received. This concludes this troubleshooting video. I hope you enjoyed it.